Where are we going?
I thought I saw some scavenger birds over here. Just wanted to see what attracted them.
For dead, it looks like.
Why would someone do that?
I don't know. But I see tracks heading in this direction. I say we follow them.
All right. Lead the way. Could it have been an animal?
No, they've been shot. I just don't know why anybody would just leave them here to rot like that. Look, another dead bison. On the hill to the right. Come on. Shot and left for dead again. But this one looks fresher.
There's a camp there. I'm gonna take a look. Cold yet. Maybe half a day since they left.
Bison's been dead about the same amount of time.
So what do you want to do?
They could still be in the area. Let's get up higher. See if we spot anything. This way. We should have a good view from up here. See anything? Arthur, look. Smoke to the north. Could be another camp.
Let's go check it out. Can talk?
I don't kill for fun. I kill when I need to. Look, more dead bison. It has to be them. Come on.
Wait up. Yeah.
Did you fools shoot those bison?
Calm down, you black or red bastard, whatever the fuck you are.
Did you shoot them?
Yes, we did. We shot them bison. We'll shoot you too if you don't get.
What business is it of yours? What? We. It's that business of mine!
Good God, you're crazy! Look, I got a family. A family. Don't shoot me.
Stand back, Charles. I'll get you some answers.
What the hell are you doing?
Why are you killing those bison and leaving them to rot?
I don't know what you're talking about.
God damn it, tell us or you're dead.
And make it look like it was Indians.
Just kill him, Arthur.
No, please, don't kill me. I'm begging you.
All right, get out of here.
Just don't shoot me, mister. I got a family.
Then run away.
Why did you do that?
He didn't need to die. Maybe he'll go tell his friends now what happens to poachers.
I've seen enough of this.
I'm heading back.
Okay. I'm gonna see if there's anything worth taking from their camp. I'll catch up with you later.
Yep. Folks seem really happy now.
Sure.
This is everything.
Good morning, Arthur.
I feel like death. Mr. Morgan, bring me some materials, and I'll be glad to make something nice for you.
I'll keep my eye out.
I apologize in advance for this stew. It needs better meat. Well, the quality's a bit lacking. We won't get much for it.
Fine, but make sure you get a good price for it.
If only it was in better condition. Let's see what we can get for it.
Don't you overcook this now, Pearson.
Many thanks, Mr. Morgan.
Ugh, why did I drink all that?
How are you holding up?
As well as can be expected.
Good.
That's enough for me. Can I tell you something?
So, how is everything?
Get it off. Life's a gift. I'll
Hey, Javier.
I heard about a house. Could be interesting.
What kind of a house?
I don't know. A couple fellas I heard in town, they said it was really freakish. A family local boogeymen, I guess. But they're crooked in every way.
So?
Well, so these boys thought they were sitting on a lot of cash. And they're highway robbers, kidnappers, apparently. They're well hidden in the woods.
That sounds pretty dubious.
Of course. Yeah, it's dubious, but there ain't much risk of getting caught.
Okay, then. Let's go take a look.
Exactly. Just take a look.
It's up north, on the other side of the river from Valentine. This way there is through Cumberland Falls, though. You know it?
Sure, more or less.
Got all you need. Let's go.
Okay, fella.
Mount up. Come on.
Pretty close now. Let's stop and go on foot.
from here. Just up the hill this way. Follow me. There's a spot up ahead where we should be able to get a good look at the place. I want to make sure we don't run into any surprises.
Sure.
Apparently, his family's been isolated for so long, they started talking in their own weird dialect. They really don't like outsiders, especially on their turf.
Well, you just keep selling me on this job, don't you?
Now, big place, right? You got your binoculars?
Well, there's a pretty big barn in the back. It's not a bad place to start looking. There must be a lot of people living here. It's a large house.
Stash could be in any one of them buildings, and who knows how many people are in there. I ain't sure about this.
Boy, I think we need to draw them out somehow. And I got an idea. Follow me.
All these trees, I can't get a proper look at the place.
Well, hopefully it'll make it harder for them to spot us, too.
Coast seems clear so far.
Yeah, so far.
Hey, keep it down. I hear voices. Come on, let's hide behind this shed. See if we can hear what they're saying.
You bustling girls at the market. No work to pride on. Shut your gopher, new, don't you? You got me ears and I'll be hunching duel from the horse.
Maybe just stay quiet.
Time one's mouth. Creepers, Finn. Don't score notions in the Dippy Plymouth's head.
Where you been now, Newt? Don't be boiling now, Pappy. I's gone but 10 minutes I was.
You can lollygag all the now day long, cause Edie takes patrol now, don't you?
What? No, Edie get all the jam!
You shut your gupper, or I'll flag her your felt, I will. You need to pull it up, boy. Up. Go guard the shed.
Go!
You understand what they're saying?
Not much of it. What are we doing out here?
Okay. Take cover by the rock over there. I'll create a little distraction, and then you jump them, okay?
What kind of distraction?
You'll see.
Turn!
All right, quick. Let's look for the stash.
They weren't shy about defending that barn. Let's check in there first.
Look what we have here.
I told you it was worth the trouble, didn't I?
Yeah. You take this. Let's split up. I'll meet you back at camp.
Sounds good.
Yep.